Hello guys, this is Virendra Singh and welcome back at MasterCAM MIL3D Tutorials and Toolpath. This is our MasterCAM MIL3D second tutorial part 3. In our MasterCAM last video, we discussed about that how we can make toolpath for a roughing operation or for a roughing purpose. And in this video, we discuss about that how we can create toolpath for a finishing purpose. So in this video, we discuss about that two different type of operations for a finishing purpose. That number one operation is known as raster, and then second one operation is known as a pencil. As you can see in our last video, we discuss about that how we can create a roughing operation. In our last one video, we discuss about first how we can create stock model. After that, the most using MasterCAM roughing operation in detail about all the parameter, that is area roughing operation. And after that, I also define how we can create again stock model. And now the next one operation is rest roughing operation. And in this video we discuss about the finishing operation. So for that, let me show you that how the operation will be looks in a for when we are doing for a finishing purpose. So that is over two different operations for a finishing purpose. The first operation is known as a raster. So let me show you in a 2D simulation how raster is machining. So raster is machining like in a that one form. After that, we also discuss about the next one operation is that is known as pencil toolpath. So pencil operation is we are using for removing small corner area. So we discuss about both of these two operation in a details. So let me show you that how we can machining that one part by the help of these two different operations. So for creating a finishing toolpath, let me create a new toolpath group. So let me first changing the name of that one toolpath group. So for changing the name of that one toolpath group, first click right click group rename. So I just have to define here rough. Now I have to just make a new toolpath group, that is finishing, that is group, new toolpath group, and I have to just define finish. I just have to minimize so that time over there will be no roughing operation will be visible at here. So now I have to just create that finishing operation. So for creating a finishing operation, I just have to copy any kind of roughing operation. So make a right click, copy, and now paste and minimize that. So I just have to copy my one roughing operation. Now I have to just for clicking parameter. At a parameter that I have to come in the first one page, that is toolpath type. Then now which type of toolpath I am using. I already doing roughing operation, now I have to do finishing operation. So I have just click on a finishing. When first I have to click when finishing, so first I have to define what is the shape of the finishing and which one operation we are using. So as we already discussed that we are using raster operation, so I just click on a raster. Then next one page is model geometry. At here at model geometry, we already select the entity and we are also defined when we are doing a finishing, so we have to remove that one stop. The next one thing is we are coming here for the toolpath control. When we are doing a finishing purpose or a finishing operation, so that time that is required that we have to define toolpath control. It means what is the boundary that where will be tool can we can control the tool. So for we have to click one chain. So for selecting that chain, I just have to click here. And I just have to define that upper chain. So I just click at one place here. Continue, continue, continue. So that time, as you can see, my upper chain is automatically selected and I just have to press OK. Now the next one step, I have to define the tool. So for defining a new tool, I just have to go in a tool library, filter, and I just have to click 8mm of ball nose. So remove. So only ball nose tool will be so visible. So I just have to define a one ball nose tool, and here what is the feed rate and what is the spindle speed. We can also comment any comment as per our requirement. Then the next one is we can define here holder, and at here the next one page is stop. So when we are doing a raster operation for a finishing purpose, so that time we don't have required any kind of stock. So we just have to unmark that one. So the next one page is that we are coming here at the cutting parameter. At here cutting parameter, first we have to define what is the cutting style or a cutting method. The cutting method, we have different type of cutting method, one way, other way, zigzag. So we are defining zigzag. Zigzag means our tool will be going that one and again I have to come. That zigzag is we already discussed when we are doing a facing operation. Tool is doing one way, again from that one place tool will be again cutting. And also I define that tool will be cutting in an optimized cutting order. Then the next one page or next one step I have to do, that is known as step over. Here at the means of the step over means the what is the step over value that I have to define what is as per the tool. You can define as per the tool. So my tool is here at the 8 mm, so I just have to define 0.15 micron 0.15 mm. And also here I have to define the percentage of tool diameter, it is constant 100 mm. And at here the next one is there is a one parameter that is known as a machining angle. So here that one parameter, that is machining angle. At here machining angle I just have defined here automatically, that is zero. So means what is the mean of zero, that tool will be machining like that one form. So I just have to input the machining angle is 45 degrees. So what will be changing will be doing, so I also define in a details. So the next one is transitions. Okay, step and cello, I don't have to require to be changed step and cello for here. At step and cello for a finishing purpose, there is one new parameter is adding, that is angle from and to. I will define or I will discuss about both of these two important parameter in a future also. Now the next one thing is linking parameter, it is also same. And the last one thing is arc or a filter or a tolerance. So I just change the tolerance value 0.01 and press OK and regenerate. So when I was just regenerating that one toolpath, so as you can see, then I just try to simulate that one. So that tool is doing in a machining in a 45 degree angle, as you can see. If I just change that machining angle is 0 degree, so that time tool is machining in like that kind of. So that is I done that one operation is known as raster roughing, raster operation. And I just make a finishing, and after the finishing operation again I have to remove or I have to machining the small area, that is at the here corner and also at the here corner. The radius of that one corner is 1.5 mm as per our drawing. So I just have to machining again for a finishing purpose, and I have to make my corner as per my requirement size in a drawing. So for that one I have to define a new operation. So for creating a new operation, I will be generating the new operation is name as pencil. So for creating a new operation, I just have to copy that one operation and paste here. So after that one I have to just again go in a parameter. First I have to select toolpath type. So toolpath type is pencil, tool model geometry, that is same, toolpath control, that will be same, tool that I have to define 3 mm of ball nose. So I just have to go in a 3 mm of ball nose. Okay, I can change my feed rate and spindle speed as per my requirement. Now the next one thing is cutting parameter. When we are doing a pencil toolpath, so in a cutting parameter page there will be lot of operations are here visible. So as you can see here, that first is cutting style or cutting method, that is we will always doing define the when we are using a pencil toolpath, that is always we are try to define, that is zigzag. At here the first one thing is that what is the step over. So when we are doing 0.3 mm, sorry, when we are machining by the help of 3 mm of ball nose, so that time here step over should be 0.08 or 0.09. then the next one thing I have to define, that is scale up height. Scale up height is automatically calculated. And the next one of the most important parameter that I have required to define, that is known as maximum number of offset. I don't have to require when we are doing a pencil toolpath. So here I have to define, that is what is the tool diameter of the last tool which we are using machining. I have to require that one defined. So when we are defining that one, 8 mm of tool, so that I automatically calculated number of offsets. And now I have to just define in next keep tool within, that is 100% as we discuss. Then next transitions. At here we discuss about the transition space. When we are doing in a transition space, make sure you have to define always, try to make straight. You can also define ramp also. Transitions means what is the movement when tool is movement for a one pass, and again tool when tool is going for a next one pass. So what the tool for going in a next one tool path, how tool will be going that time. So that is known as a transitions. The next step and cello, all the linking parameter all will be same. Just press OK and regenerate. So when we, as you can see here, we are regenerating that one operation. So after regenerating of that one operation, that what I have to do, let me show you in a 3D simulation all the operation, all the roughing operation as well as all the finishing operation. So for simulation, all these operation, as you can see in our last one operation, I just simulate all the roughing operations. I don't go for a roughing operation. I just go for a 3D simulation. Roughing operation is only one, then that one finishing and that one finishing, and I just go for a 3D simulation. So as you can see here, our new page is open. That first is stock area. So I just have to play that one operation. So first operation, that is over stock, that is over also roughing operation. So after roughing operation, the next one is finishing operation. So let me show you that how it will be machining. As you can see in a 3D simulation, that it is machining in a very smooth way. There will be no mark, or a finishing is a very good. So that's why we are mostly try to using raster operation for a die or mold, or for a that kind of operation, that kind of profile. So raster operation is try to remove the maximum area of material in a 45 degree of angle. We are defining here 45 degree of angle, so because of when we are defining 45 degree of angle, so that time it will be machining a very smooth way, or our tool path will be, and also our part is, part finishing is also very well. So as you can see, our raster operation finishing, as you can see here, then the next one operation finishing, that is known as a pencil. So I also play pencil tool path. So as you can see here, my pencil tool path is going like that. It's also remove the maximum area of material, as you can see here. So in a pencil tool path, first it is removing the bottom to top area. First it's removing the maximum material from the bottom area, then it will be also removing the material from that upper area also. So let me show you that it is also removing the material from that one first, then second is that one. So it will make material removing from all the surfaces as per our model. So thank you very much. I wish you understand all the operations. So in MasterCAD Mill 2D tutorial second, we discuss about that three operations. The number one is for a roughing purpose, area roughing operation, and for a finishing purpose we are learning two new operations. The number one is raster and the second one is pencil tool path. So I wish you understand all the things. So thank you very much. I wish be connected and updated for the more videos.